Hi, welcome to Learning Monkey. I am Vikram. In this class, we'll try to solve a problem called multiply the middle number with the maximum of three numbers. So among three numbers, we have to multiply the middle number with the maximum of those three numbers. So this is the program. So the concept that we have on the board is the way in which the questions will be asked in the placement exam. This is how you will be asked in the placement exam. So what this states is, these are the test cases. So on these test cases, and you will be provided with an online compiler. So within the test, you will be provided with an online compiler. So on that compiler, so they will provide the code also. You will be provided with the code also. And these are the test cases. And based upon these test cases, you have to get these results also. So you have to get these results also. So all this work, so testing the test cases, there is no need for you to give the test cases. It is all done by the compiler at the back end. So what you have to do is, we have to write the code with the visualization of these test cases. So while writing the code, we should have this kind of visualization. So based upon these test cases, we have to analyze the code and we have to write the code. So here the code is also provided, but what we have to do, code is provided, what we have to do is, there will be some logical errors. So there will be some logical errors. With this, we are not going to get the right output. So with this logic, so whatever that is there in the green color code, it is the logic of the program. So within this logic, there are some errors. So we have to identify those errors and we have to correct those errors there itself. So within that environment, we have to correct the errors when we have to submit the program. So after submitting, it will check for multiple test cases. It will test for your program will be tested on multiple test cases. If all those cases has been gone through, so you'll get the right output. So it states that you have successfully completed the program. So we have to go to the next problem. So this is how the bits were asked. This is one of the ways where we are not required to write the code. Code will be provided, we have to correct the code and we have to submit it to the compiler. So all the testing is also done by the compiler. Okay, so let's start our first program. So this is our first program on this kind of questions. So here the test cases, so what they are asking is, we have to multiply the middle number with the maximum of three numbers. So you will be provided with three numbers. Here also three numbers are provided. The three numbers are 5, 7, 4. What we have to do is, we have to find the middle number. So generally we expect that the middle number is 7. No, it is not. So among these three, which one, if they are arranged in the increasing order, which one is going to be the middle number? So obviously the middle number, if we arrange them, it is, so no need to arrange them also. So we have to think of it. Okay, so here the middle number is 5. So this middle number has to be multiplied with the maximum of three numbers. The maximum of three numbers is 7. So whenever we multiply 5 and 7, the output is going to be 35. Similarly, for this test case, the middle number is 12, and it is 12 into 13, it is going to be 156. Okay, this is the logic. So we have to find the we have to correct this logic. So what this logic is, so these three lines are the very important lines of the code. First, we have to identify which part of the program is going to have the logic. So the logic states that first we are going to find the maximum of three numbers, and next we have to find the minimum of three numbers. With that, we are going to get the middle number among the three numbers. So this logic is going to find the middle number. So among these three numbers, we have to find the middle number. So you are randomly provided with 5, 7, 4, but the middle number is going to be 5. It is not in the middle position. Here they are not asking the middle position number, they are asking the value which comes if they are arranged in ascending order. So for that to happen, For that to happen, we have to find the maximum number and minimum number. Using the maximum number and minimum number, we will get the middle number. And the logic for the middle number is, this is the logic. Okay, whether we have to check whether it is identifying the correct maximum number or not. And we have to check whether this logic is going to identify the correct minimum number or not. So how we are going to solve that is, and the variables are, first we will check the variables. It is A, B, C. Whenever the function call is made, 5, 7, 4 will be transferred to A, B, C. And the variables within this is result, min, max, mid. So the result is used here. In the result, we are going to multiply the maximum and mid, and this result will be submitted back. So this is how the program is organized. Okay, so let's try to execute, let's try to identify the logic for this program. First, we will try to write the logic for this program, and later we'll write our own logic. Which is by using this ternary operators. Now, after that, we will correct the program. Okay. First, what we are going to do, and in the ternary operator concept, we have explained this program also. How to find the maximum of three numbers and how to find the minimum of three numbers. And that logic we are going to understand now. So here, let's assume that, for example, if we have three numbers, we'll take the same test case 4, 5, 7, 4. So among this, to find the maximum number, to write the logic with the ternary operator. So how the ternary operator works? First, the condition will be there, and if the condition is true, this part of the program has to be executed. If the condition is false, this statement will get executed. So this is how the ternary operator will work. So to identify the maximum of three numbers, what we have to do, so we will consider this as A, this as B, and this as C, three variables. What is the logic is, if the condition is, if A is greater than B, so first we will check these two numbers. So among the greatest among these two, so what is the simple logic? So first we will take two numbers and we will check the greatest among those two numbers. So the greatest among those will be checked with the third variable. So among those, the greatest is going to be the greatest among three numbers. We are finding the maximum number. So to find the maximum number, first we have to take two variables, values in the two variables, and we have to identify the greatest among them. So the greatest among them, further the condition is, if A is greater than B. So if it is true, what does that mean? If it is true, means A is greater. Now what we have to do, A has to be verified with C. Okay, A has to be verified with C. If this is true, then the condition we are going to write. So what we have to do, we have to verify A greater than C. If this is also true, then what it is going to state, that the greater is A. If this is true, then this part, so here this is the, if the condition is true, this part will get executed. If it is false, this part will get executed. So we'll write that part later. First, what we have to do, if A is greater than B, if it is true, then we have to compare the great A with C. If A is greater than C, if that is also true, it means that among the three numbers, A is the greatest one. So this one, A, has to be identified. If that is false, A is not greater than C, means C is greater. So the output has to be C. The maximum is going to be C. So when we are going to come to this place, whenever this condition is true, if this condition is false, at the starting point only, if this condition is false. So what does that mean? A is greater than B is false, means B is greater. Now what we have to do, we have to compare B with the remaining variable, which is C. Okay, so the condition is, if this is false, if this is true means this part will get executed. If this is false means this part will get executed. So what it states, what we have to write here, we have to write B is greater, we have to check the condition. So again we are writing some another ternary operator conditions. See here, also a ternary operator condition. So this is the entire part that will get verified. Okay, now if this is false, now we have to check whether B is greater than C or not. If it is true, what is the greatest among, what is the maximum among all these three? It is B. Okay, and if it is false, the output is going to be C. So this is the final bracket. So this is for this and this is for the, okay, so this is not required. Okay, this is the final output to find the maximum, to find the max. This is the code for max. What is the code for min? Min means the same logic, but it is less than. Same logic, but it is less than. If A is less than B, sorry, if A is less than B, it means that among A and B, if it is true, it means that among A and B, B is the small, among A and B, A is the smaller one. So if it is true, now we have to check A with C. If it is less than C, it is also true, means among the three elements, A is the smaller one. If this condition is false, means among the three elements, C is the smaller one. Okay, so this is how the condition has to be written. This is how the condition has to be written, and this is the closing brace for this condition. This is the closing brace. Okay, and for this, this is the closing brace. If this condition is false, if A is not less than B, A is not less than B means B is less than A. So we have to check now B with C, whether B is less than C or not. If it is true, so again brace, if it is true, then B is smaller, B is min, else C is min. Okay, so this is the logic. So is it in the same way? No, it is not there. See here, this is the outermost logic, outermost parenthesis, and we have to end this here, and here another semicolon has to be there. Another semicolon has to be there after that this condition. So this is the mistake that is there in the program. Similarly for this also, here another semicolon, and this has to be, this has to be closed, and after that semicolon. So that separates this from that. So we will so this confusion is, this is how they will get, they will confuse us. So that we have to understand. So don't go with this logic. First you write your own logic, which is, which looks very similar to this program. If it works, then try to apply the same on that area. So how you are going to solve, it is your personal approach. So this is how I am going to solve this problems. Okay, now we got the max and minimum, and this is the logic for, they have given the logic to find the mid value. So is it working? Is it the way to get the mid value? So with this you are going to get the logic for to find the mid value among the three numbers also. So what is the logic? It is A plus B plus C. So in our case it is 574. 574 means it is 12 plus 4, 16, minus min plus max. Min plus max means among this min is 4 and max is 7. It is 11. And if you subtract that, that is, we are going to get 5. What is the mid value between 4, 5 and 7? It is 5. We got the middle value. So this is the right logic for getting the mid value. So test for another condition also. So the test case is 11, 12, 13. So among this, 11 plus 12 plus 13, it is going to be 36. And min plus max. Min plus max means it is 11 plus 12. It is 24. 36 minus 24. Obviously, it is going to be 12. So what is the middle value? It is 12. So this is the right logic. So no need to disturb this. So just make the changes. These are the changes that we have to do in these two lines of the code. With that, we are going to get that, we are going to get the right output. So it is definitely going to work. So this logic is definitely going to work. We have to change this line of code with this, in this line of code, and we have to change this line of code with this line of code. So what we have to understand is how to write the logic. We, if you are good at writing the logic, the concepts of ternary operator, min and max, how to find the minimum among the three elements, this example has already been discussed. Okay, so this is the logic for this program. Hope you got the clarity on this concept. Thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon for the latest updates. And if you have any doubts regarding this concept, please post your doubt in the comment section below. And if you feel that this video is helpful to you, please give us a like symbol and please share this video with your friends so that they will also get benefited. Thanks for watching.